morning and welcome to Patriot TV.
I'm Bryn.
And I'm Josie.
Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'm Che.
I'm Lexi.
And I'm Ayla.
And here's Finish the Lyric Christmas Edition.
I'm here with
Ayla from 8th grade.
And
Lily from 8th grade.
And you guys are doing Guess the Christmas Song.
Don't know this song.
Don't make me fall in love again if you want me here next year.
Hi, I'm Ayla and I'm here with
Marissa from 8th grade.
And
Isabel from 8th grade.
And they're here to Guess the Christmas Song.
You better not howl when I'm going to die.
Hi, I'm Ayla and I'm here with
Payne.
And
Shuki.
And they're here to guess the Christmas song.
Algorithm base, I hate you! Geometry mention who? I hate you. Hate you eternally!
Hey guys, today we're going to be doing a speed walking competition for a prize.
I'm Savannah, I'm here with
Logan,
Max.
And who do you think's going to win?
Me.
I think I'm going to win.
I won. We stand on business. How's that feel?
Not that good.
Three names.
Bennett, Cooper.
Who do you think's going to win?
Bennett.
Me, bro.
I won. How do you feel about losing?
Very, very bad.
What are your names?
Brent.
Tristan.
Who do you think's gonna win?
Me.
Brent.
Brent's and I won. How do you feel about losing?
Pretty bad.
What's your names?
Austin.
Hunter.
Who do you think's gonna win?
Me.
Probably Austin.
I'm Austin, I won. How do you feel about losing?
It's alright, but wish I won.
I'm Austin, I think I'm gonna win.
I'm Bryson, I think I'm gonna win.
I'm Bennett, I think I'm gonna win.
I'm Max, and Bennett's bad.
Yeah,
just
call him
Catalyst,
like.
I'm Branson, I think I'm gonna cut it up today.
I'm Max, and I'm gonna dust Branson. Obviously won, Branson's dust. What do you have to say?
Good game.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Lily.
I'm Mackenzie.
And
Lindsay.
I'm Penny.
And I'm Zoe.
And today we're doing short and tall people advantages and disadvantages.
It's gonna.
To finish our student shout-out segment, here is the last for the first semester.
For Ms. Pruitt, Dylan Seidenberg for bringing his passion to our SEL work here at Dunstan and helping facilitate a lesson. Keep up the good work.
From Mr. Fabian, shout-out to the best TAs, Kaya, Jake, Megan, Austin, and Cooper. Thank you for all your work this semester in PE.
Also for Mr. Fabian, both 6 and 7 volleyball teams who finished up their regular season with 4-game sweeps of Carmody.
From Ms. Saliver and Mr. Starkey, both of their advice classes for being a wonderful start to each day. They both appreciate the positive attitudes and smiles.
From just Mr. Starkey to his TAs, Clarissa, Nathan, and Ian for being incredible this semester. Thank you for all your help and hard work.
From just Ms. Saliver, all of the students who made incredible growth on the winter math test. Way to go, readers.
From Mr. Menard, Colton Hurdle, thank you for being his personal 3D printer technician and always stepping up to help my 6th grade and 7th grade students navigate their way around the workshop and exploration of STEM.
Mrs. Higginbotham has quite a bit. First, shout out to Elijah and Lillian in 4th period for being the Socratic Seminar MVPs for Flower for Alvaro. You both did an excellent job engaging in the discussion and making sure all voices were heard.
Then to Sophia Q for being my TA this semester. Thank you for all the hard work.
Also to Willow H in 2nd period for being our classroom caretaker of Wilfred, our class peace lord. You have kept a piece of our room vibrant all semester.
Finally, for Ms. Higginbotham, shout out to 6th graders Jackson and Mirage for help cleaning up the spots in the cafeteria during breakfast. You both exemplify what it means to do the right thing even when no one is watching. Well done.
To end our shout out segment for Mrs. Boucher, Penny Bishop, Zoe Economo, and Collier Fox for all semester choosing to come to class with a positive attitude and your continued commitment to your education. Thank you and congratulations on achieving greatness.
There were a few fun activities which happened across the school last week.
In 7th grade science, Mrs. Fisher's students dissected chickens.
Mrs. Miller hosted an art show for parents and students to come check out all of the great work. Decorating trees, exchanging gifts, and singing songs about Santa Claus. It's what most people think of when they think of Christmas. But for Christians, December 25th has a more important significance. The holiday honors the birth of Jesus Christ some 2,000 years ago. But we bet you didn't know that in the early years of Christianity, Christians didn't celebrate Christmas at all. In fact, there is no mention of December 25th in the Bible. Early Christians couldn't even agree on which date Jesus was actually born. It was only in the 3rd century that December 25th became the official celebration of the birth of Jesus, most likely because it coincided with already existing pagan festivals. By the end of the 8th century, Christmas was widely celebrated across Europe. But its pagan roots died hard, and for many centuries people marked the holiday with wild parties, similar to Mardi Gras celebrations. This would lead some religious purists, such as the Puritan settlers of colonial America, to oppose Christmas celebrations. In 1644, the Massachusetts legislature fined anyone who observed Christmas 5 shillings, which was a lot of money at the time. In fact, Christmas as we know it didn't really begin until the 1800s. That's when Germany's Prince Albert brought his country's longtime tradition of decorating evergreen trees to England after his marriage to Queen Victoria. When an image of the royal family next to their 40-foot Christmas tree was published in American magazines in 1848, the custom caught on in the United States as well. The tradition of sending Christmas cards also started in England around the same time. Giving gifts is a relatively old Christmas tradition, with roots going back many centuries. At first, gift-giving had religious significance, to remind people of the gifts brought to baby Jesus by the three kings. But the Industrial Revolution and the rise of advertising in the 19th and 20th centuries made Christmas the commercial holiday it is today, even as it continues to have religious meaning for Christians. What about the most famous of all Christmas characters, Santa Claus? He's actually based on Saint Nicholas of Myra, a Dutch saint famous for giving gifts, who is known as Sinterklaas. In early incarnations, Santa Claus wore many different colors. But after a Coca-Cola ad in the 1930s showed him wearing red and white, the image stuck. From the date of the holiday itself to the traditions associated with it, Christmas has a long and colorful history. We bet you didn't know.
Thanks for watching PTV this semester.
We leave you with the highlights from the past semester as well as teachers being teachers.
Have a wonderful week and happy holidays.
Bye.
The mood is right, the spirit's up. We're here tonight, and that's enough. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time.